Greetings and salutations, and welcome back to Jill of the Jungle. Right, so we've dealt with the bonus level, so we drop back down here. No falling damage, as you said, may note. Can't go any further. So, let's just say level 8. Jill sneaks into Arg's dungeon. I have no idea who Arg is, or why they have a dungeon. See those? Breakable blocks. That's more like it. And up we go. Firebirds. X-Firebirds. Could be worse, they could be Thunderbirds. Not the male plank, there's nothing wrong with that. I can use that. Okay, now let's head down to the right. Now that we've acquired that key, which lets us get through this door. And once again, we enter the jungle map. The gate closes behind us. Ah, another level note. Another bonus level, that is, sorry. It is another level. We can't get through here just yet. So, let's remember that that's there. Oops. Level 9 and level 10 are here. We can just keep going, but we're blocked by gem gates. So, let's try level 9. Makes sense. Jill enters the Phoenix Maze. Okay, are there Phoenixes rather than Firebirds? One problem with Jill of the Jungle, there are some minor rendering issues. You don't always see these doors and such like updates needed. Ah, that's what's happening. Okay, you notice these grey pillars? Go here, do that. You notice that one's gone? As I said, these things don't always update while they're still on screen, rather. It's less a matter of time. Oops, I think that's told us that we're not allowed to touch water in this form. Less a matter of time than of... position on the screen, or lack thereof. You may notice that these ghosts... Oh, hey, we can kill them. I thought they couldn't be killed. Nice. We don't seem to get any points for doing so, however. Oh, kittens! And as you notice, when we die, we disintegrate. Not soft on you, that. Not to mention the dramatic laughter. I think those waterfalls would be fine for Jill, but of course not for our Phoenix. That waterfall there is an impassable barrier. I presume that it's filling up the space in the tunnel such that we can't simply fly around it. Or, you know, it's a platform game and the third dimension doesn't exist. One of the two. I think more likely the former, really. Probably has nothing to do with the genre of game. There we go. And we now have four keys, and I think that's what's called for to get us out. Touching this icon a second time doesn't do anything. Doesn't do anything while we're in Phoenix form, that is. And alas, back to Jill. As much as I like Jill, it's a little more fun in the alternate forms that we can get. And yes, I did use the plural. Jill enters the jungle map. Jill ventures into the night's puzzle. Oh yes, this one's neat. I'm just going to say it quickly. So, I've just saved. See these knights? This one does it. This is completely inert. This one, not so much. The knight slices Jill in half. You can see activating that switch renders him inert. Activating that switch activates that knight. That's a nice animation, I think. Maybe one of these. Okay, well, he's inert now, so we can go around this way. I'm guessing there's probably... Yes, friend, it's him in that. Allowing a spy pass, so we take the lift, activate that switch. It's that sort of level. Lots and lots of switches. Now, this is where that that rendering issue becomes a bit of a nuisance. You see, these switches control these pillars, and we have to figure out the appropriate combination. However, the pillars won't update on screen until you move off screen. There, you see. As you can see, they might not be visible, but they are palpable. Go out and come back in. There it is. Aha, there we go. A little bit of guesswork, but so it goes. Can be a little hasty right here. Now, as you may have guessed, these blue blocks are temporary, calling for some timing in your platform. You can use the grey blocks as permanent blocks to a degree at least. Just in time. Good, good. There's another key to be had. Excellent, I think we have all the keys. Nice. Once again, Jill enters the jungle map. We now have 2 gems. I don't think that helps us with the bonus area, though. No. Oh, I think maybe we access it from the other direction. I'm not sure. That's one bit that I don't remember clearly or found. Anyway, use the gems to get out here. Our jump power-up gets us up here if we so desire. And we do. Ah, I think this might activate the bonus. So if we now take the elevator back, we... And voila, no pillars. Tim, 1992. To renew. That's, who was Tim again? He was one of the people at Epic Mega Games, if I'm not much mistaken, although I forget his name offhand. His surname, that is. I can guess at his first name. Right, so do we want to go straight into level 11? Bypass it? Ah, and here's the finish of the game. You can see once again we need 2 gems to get through. So we have only 2 two directions in which to go. We can go down here or straight into level 11. Let's go down here, why not? Levels 12 and 13. Let's do it backwards. 13 first. Jill enters yet another puzzle. Dear, oh dear. Oh, that was evil. Must be on the bottom of the world with all these antipodes. And we are now a frog. With shift hopping and alt leaping. They're the same thing, but oh well. Yes, we have absolutely no attack in this form. But we can jump. And it makes a cute noise. This is slightly more like it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I know that it says go up, but I have some vengeance to take. Or more accurately, I have some enemies to clear out. Not that it makes much difference. I forget what happens if we fly up here. I think this is where we're supposed to go. I will be back in a moment. So I've technically done this in an inefficient manner, but oh well, I don't care. All the way up here. There's a gem and banners with some points in there. They're quite nice flags, actually. There we go, we want that gem. I don't know what the M stands for. Again, this slightly trippy, in this case, double, I suppose, horizon line, or whatever this is in the background. I like it. You see, this game is very slightly trippy, not entirely so. Jill enters the jungle map. Alas, we don't get to stay a Firebird. The underground river. Oh, this is another good level, as I recall. So we need at least 4 gems to get past this. So what happens if we jump into the water? We disintegrate. Lovely. So we're not going to do that. Yes, so as Jill, we can jump through these unhindered. It's going to make life easier on myself by clearing out some of the enemies as Jill. I think it is handy to attack our enemies from a position from which they cannot retaliate. Unfair? Maybe. Do I care? No. What can I say? I usually play a mage, so attacking my enemies from a position from which they cannot counterattack is somewhat intuitive to me. I suppose that's what I get. Still, I'm sticking to that. Now, little fishy this one. But, as you can see, shift is swim. That basically lets us swim up. Although that doesn't really do anything that up doesn't do better. And alt allows us to shoot. Shooting shells. Whoops, entirely clear. I entirely missed that Firebird. That Phoenix. Remember, you can shoot a fish bullet by pressing Alt or the Fire button on your joystick. So, whatever they are, they're called fish bullets. I don't know. What is that green thing? Is that some sort of fanged tadpole? It hurts. A little bit mazy, but it's nowhere near as bad as the mazes in Commander Keen, I do think. Ah, kittens. Of course, it helps that I am very familiar with the levels. Not so familiar that I don't get lost, but familiar enough that there's little real surprise in them for me. You might think that would make them get a little boring, but I don't know, as I said, it's somewhat of a comfort game for me, so it's pleasant to revisit these things, these places and these encounters. Right, transform back into Jill. Open up all the gates, grab one last gem and head out back into the jungle map. Now, we have 2 gems. I think we can actually finish the game at this point. But we won't. We have 1 more level to complete, so let's do that. Level 11, Jill creeps into the dark forest. Oh yes, I remember this one. Okay, I remember them all, I'm not sure, but this one stands out for me as somewhat memorable. Scum. As harmless as I am in frog form, most of these are nasty pieces of work. They're difficult to hit, that's the problem. Yeah, I thought I remembered someone on this level. Ooh, that was close. That was aiming for the ant, but I'd rather get the frog, quite frankly. Now, that's a problem for us. Hit around. Yes, actually, that's true. Can't go further down? No. We can get points. Yaha. Hit up and around, bypassing this pond. Flip the switch. And yeah, voila, the pond is covered over. So we can cross back if we should so desire. I think we do come back in a little while. Ooh, that was a little close. I'm not sure there's any real point to call him even where he was, but oh well. Oh, I don't have the key. Oh, great. There are now 2 frogs at the bottom of this. Oh well, there's little 4s, I think. Ah, kittens, you scum. This place is full of frogs. Who would have thought my main dueling partner in a platformer would be a tiny frog? So even the game agrees with me. Who would have thought it? Yeah! Okay, yes, strike. We have our key. We can add our key here. There we go. Physics was giving me a little bit of trouble for a moment there. Yes, there it is. Oh, I don't actually know what. Do quantum phoenixes have gender? Ow. Well, that one doesn't anymore. I suppose that's a little cool, I am sorry. Once again, Joel enters the jungle map. And that, I believe, is that. Onward to the finish. Joel enters the plateau. Last level. As it's a plateau, you can see that we have the jungle spread out below us there. There's a lake in the background. While I run away from the bees. Here we go, the bees have dissipated. As everyone knows, bees evaporate after a short while. Well known fact that. Oh, ow. Oh no! I got incinerated. Lovely. There we go. The physics on that spinning blade is a little odd. Is it physics R? As though they're quite cool? Physics is used there as essentially a mass now, isn't it? You're not saying that there are multiple physics? Or are you? How? While I get killed by bees? No, go away. Whew. I have next to no health left. Maybe less pondering of physics, more defeating my enemies. Nah. So I'm pretty sure it's physics is, not physics are. Because it's being used as a mass noun. As a single body of knowledge. Epic! Joel reaches the ending. Now sit back and enjoy. I think I might have been able to reach a little more to the left there, I'm not sure. Oh well. I'm not doing anything here, by the way, this is just a cutscene. Zzzt. Flying through the stars and planets, which is impressive for a thing apparently made of fire. No, foof. And we encountered enormous glowing mushrooms, that's pretty cool. I like the colours here. 500 miles away from her starting point, Jill wanders into a strange and mystical grove of mushrooms. Transforming back into her human form, she stops to ponder the situation. This is a place unlike anything seen by the eyes of a human. What unspeakable forces of nature lie beyond the grove? Can a lady like Jill uncover the mysteries of this place and escape without messing up her blonde hair? Find the answers in Jill Goes Underground, the startling sequel, and also Jill Saves the Prince, your ultimate quest. Just when you thought it was over, the Jill series continues. In Volume 2, Jill Goes Underground, explore Montezuma's castle, discover the land of eternal weirdness, venture into the demon's hideout. With lots of new graphics, levels, sound effects, and music. In Volume 3, Jill Saves the Prince, journey through a castle filled with bats and knights. Explore the airy and the mega puzzle, then battle your way onto a ship. Features an overhead view jungle map. Much, 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 much more. Congratulations, you have conquered the jungle. We hope you've enjoyed playing Jill of the Jungle. I did, yes. The Epic Design Team, there you are, Tim Sweeney. Is that presumably the Tim previously mentioned in the bonus level? John Pellet Powerwright, Dan McFrone, I suppose that's pronounced, and Joe Hitchens. I probably mispronounced at least one of those names. the Frolic one, and possibly some of the others too. My apologies if I did. Ah. There we go. And that is Jill of the Jungle Episode 1. Thank you very much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed it. I did. Again, this is one of my favourite games. Thank you for watching, stay well, and goodbye for now.